Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom. Listen, you're not listening.
I am listening because I know the Bible very well.
Read. Evidently, you know, you got on pants.
They're here, right?
You got on pants.
I'm not Muslim. And that's who causes it. All right, real fast.
Read
it.
Give me Psalms 149. What is that, 17, 149?
With this lady. Hold on, look, got white. Jacob.
19.
147, 19. Hey, real fast. Hey, young lady. You know the Bible, right? You know the Bible?
All right,
I'm going to show you. Okay, you should know this verse then, right? Psalms chapter 147, verse 19.
Bring it out.
He saw his word unto Jacob. Who's Jacob?
Jacob is the one who had the
covenant. So where's
Jacob?
No, that's Joseph.
Yeah, his son.
Jacob is the father of the Israelites. What do the Israelites look like? Yeah, I know they're the tribes, but what do they look like? If we were to say who's the Israelites today, what would they look like? Hold that Psalm in 1:5.
Bring it out.
Real fast. So we can cut. Hey, and I'm going to answer your question. Hey, brother, about Israel. I'm going to answer your question real fast. Just hold on. Let me deal with her real fast. You got it? Song of Solomon 105. Real fast. Because what we're here to do is to give you your identity back, people. Hold up, bro. Hold up. Hold your peace until we're done. When we're done, no, this is our identity because you don't know anything. Let me show you how much fiction it is. You got it? Song of Solomon, chapter 1, verse 5. I am black. Are you listening, brother?
That's fiction.
Solomon, the king of all Israel, said what? I am black. I am what? I am black. But comely. But comely meaning I'm black and I'm beautiful. That's the king of Israel speaking right now, right? Go back to Psalm. I'm going to show you how much fictional it is.
You're never going to reach him.
Hey, what'd you say, Home Slice?
I'll put a chain of custody on that shit to see who actually, like, you know.
Yeah, I don't even know what you said.
Yeah, I know.
Psalms chapter 147, verse 19.
Bring it out.
He showed his word unto Jacob. Jacob is what? The Israelites. Black, Hispanic, and Native American.
That's
Lord,
right.
His statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He have not dealt so with any nation. And as for his judgments, they have not known them. So as for his judgments, his laws, his statutes, and commandments only concern his people and nobody else. See, the reason why people like you assume that this is a fairy tale book, I'm saying people like you assume that it's a fairy tale book is because you're rebelling against Christianity. You're not rebelling against the Bible. They're two separate things. Yeah. I'm going to show you how. Revelations 1 and 14. I'm going to show you how.
I know
real
my
fast.
Ancestors, see, that's a plagiarization of what my ancestors
are. What's your ancestors? What's your ancestors? Who are they?
The original Egyptians.
Who? The original Egyptians? So,
I can't call them
are the Egyptians,
that's a Greek name,
listen,
so
are the Egyptians, what you don't know, that's the funny part about brothers like you. You don't even know that Egypt was conquered by the Greeks
exactly.
In 333
that's
BC. So
Egypt.
A lot of the history that
that's
you think.
faith you're talking about is the white man. Right. You can't read the hieroglyphs. Stop talking to me like you can read it. Hey, tell me how to get the Moravian in the Egyptian language. I bet you can't do that. Can you do it? Can you do it? You can't read. You ain't deciphered hieroglyphs. You a Negro from the ghetto. Stop talking to me like you intelligent, brother. Now, I'm going to show you something. Israel, because I heard you on the sideline about the name and the country didn't exist until 1948, right? I'm going to show you something. Where did those people that claim to be Israel come from? What country?
They came from Germany.
Okay, so when it says Israel, that's an English version, not a German version. So the word Yasha'Allah in Hebrew means that.
But
be quiet, Edomite. Listen to what I'm saying. You're not listening, so you understand. So you understand. Listen to what I'm saying.
It's another European.
Hey, bro, are you going to stop talking and let me get my point out? I'm going to show you. That's not a German rendition of the word. It's an English rendition of the word.
Of what name?
Of Israel. You're not, are you paying attention?
That was all Northeast Africa.
That's what it's called.
It was all Northeast
it's Northeast Africa. We're not disputing that, but I'm going to show you Deuteronomy 28 and 68. The show, let's see if the Bible's a true book or Facebook. Let me see if this is a fake book or not. You got it? Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again. Like you said, Egypt is a Greek word. You know what that word means? You should stop talking. You know why you talk? You know why you got diarrhea in the mouth right now? It's so you can have an excuse to say, I didn't learn nothing today. Read. Hey, Edomite. Hey, Edomite, chill out. What are you, a sodomite or something?
I bet you look like a fucking
asshole. I bet you, I know, that's what you are. You look like Ringo Starr. Come on. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again. Because it's funny how the brother said that that's a Greek language, a word for Egypt. You know what it means? Go back to Exodus. Go to Exodus 20.
If you disagree, why don't you keep moving? If you disagree, why you still
have? I'll show you what it means.
Oh, really? Huh?
I'm going to help you out right now.
I think you need to keep it moving. If you disagree, keep it moving.
Chapter 20 and verse 2. I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. So the word Egypt means the house of bondage. That's what it means. You know why you don't agree with the Bible? Because it has nothing to do with you. I wouldn't agree with it neither. Go back to Deuteronomy 28:68. And you in cahoots with your slave master, Mr. Revolutionary Man. You know, you a chocolate covered Edomite to me, bro. You in cahoots with him. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again. So what is Egypt mean? Bondage, right? Are your people free or in bondage, Mr. Revolutionary Man?
Mine is in
bondage. Yeah, so me and you ain't the same people, or are we?
Well, no, the difference
yeah
is
or nay?
I know my history, and you're looking for...
Are you in bondage? Are you in bondage? Yes
That's
or no?
Different.
Are you in bondage? Yes or no?
Yes, I am.
Yes, you are. So go to one of your Egyptian books and show me on the hieroglyphs that it would told you you would go into slavery to the white man. Where's it at?
It's all on the temple walls.
Boom. You know what's on the walls? It's when we were slaves to them.
That's right.
You crazy brother. We were slaves. No, I never said that. The Israelites was enslaved to the Egyptians.
That's right.
Another dark-skinned people.
That's right.
No, yes, I'm serious. Just like everybody else
they
on the planet during their heyday. Listen, bro, you're crazy or something. The Egyptians, are you saying that they didn't have no slaves?
I'm going to say this, bro.
Yes or no? Did they have slaves, yeah or nay? Listen, did they have slaves, yeah or nay? Did they have slaves, yeah or nay? So you just refuse to answer? Did they have slaves, yes or no? Oh, so the Egyptians didn't have no slaves. You crazy as heck, because he just said it was written all on the temple walls, you lying Negro. Yeah, right.
You sure? Or not,
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again. Pay attention. God said that you're going to be sick and put into Egypt again. With ships.
With
what? With ships. So show me on the pyramid walls that we were going to be housed on slave ships and brought. Yeah, listen. No, we're not going to go where you want to go, bro. Show me where it's at. Huh? We just read what Solomon said. We just
to deceive black
people. We are the Jews, crazy. We're the Jews. Read it again. And the Lord shall bring thee. Well, which one is it, bro? We are or we are not?
What does Jew mean?
Now, I don't care about all that word semantic. Are we the Jews or not? Yay or nay? Okay, then pay attention to what I'm saying then. If we're in agreement, then you should stop talking right now.
Because, once again, Israel, all that is fictional,
bro. Okay,
fictional.
Tell me if this is fictional.
That's fictional.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
So
my question to you is, did we go into slaves? Did we go into slavery? Are you listening? All right, let's remove the word Israel. Did we go into slavery? How was our mode of transportation?
Some of us was already here.
We're not disputing that. Because the Bible says some of us was already here. What I'm saying to you is, we as a people, what was our mode of transportation over here? What about into Germany?
Germany?
Russia.
How did anybody get across?
China.
Those people were forced back through wars, through many wars.
The black people that's over there now in Germany that had experiments done on them because of their racial makeup, how did they get there?
Some was already there, so you got to understand. Like, we already circumvented the planet, so everyone.
I'm not talking about that. Listen, those lands was conquered by people, and you were dispersed throughout every land on the planet. All right, that's why you'll find black people in Russia, in southern Russia. By way of slave ships, listen to this. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. So we were brought here on cargo slave ships. Is that a fairy tale or is that not true? We're the only race of people that it happened to. It didn't happen to nobody else. So if it's true, let's read it again. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt slavery. Again, with shit. The Romans done it to us. You are the Romans, devil. Stop talking. That's who you are. By the way, whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. So Moses said, just like how he wrote it in the Bible, it's going to happen. You never see your homeland again. Where you from, black man, revolutionary black man? Where you from? Did you say you from Egypt? Won't you got Egypt? The brother that can't read a hieroglyph? Spanish is the most common language in America. Can you speak Spanish at least? I don't care what it was. I'm asking you, can you do it? So you can't speak Spanish. You can't get a good job. You can't get out of the ghetto. And you expect me to believe that you can read the hieroglyphs on the wall. Then you don't know. Then guess who translated it for you and gave you the information you think you got? That's no. Who? Anti-Sheikh Diop? Who? Ivan Van Sertima? Which one? Which one of them? Which one?
All of them.
Champollion. Jean Champollion is the one who's the father of Egyptology. The white man. Your oppressor that you want to align yourself with. Read it again. Thou shalt see it no more again. Did you see your homeland? Because everybody else had the ability to have dual citizenship in their land. They could go to and from Ireland when they want. They could go to England and back to America when they want. You can't. You're not even allowed to leave Homewood in the East Liberty without being in the fear of being put to death for your black skin. You talk too much, brother. You're diarrhea in the mouth. Verse 48.
Bring it out.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 48.
Bring it out.
Therefore shall thou serve thine enemies. You're not serving your enemies right now. You don't serve your enemies right now. Do he serve you or you serve him? Whose face is on the money? Whose face is on? Because you represent your home nation and you open up your mouth. If you wouldn't have said nothing, we wouldn't have entertained you. Guess whose money is, whose face is on it? Guess whose face is on it? My oppressor.
Right. All right. white man.
That's my oppressor. Read it again. Therefore shall thou serve thine enemy. That's your enemy. You serve him. You get up and go to work for him. You depend on him for your Section 8.
That's right.
You depend on him for your identity of what beauty is.
Right.
Read.
Just like that fiction.
Which the Lord shall send against thee in hunger. Do you not serve your enemy for food? Mr. Revolutionary Man catching the bus that don't have no industry. You so smart and intelligent and you can't get yourself out the ghetto.
Right.
And in thirst and in nakedness. So for your water and your clothing, do you not have to depend on your oppressor? You better wake up or you're going to die in America.
That's right.
But my question to you is, are you listening?
You can't find that.
Do you have to serve the white man for your food
you
water? Stop talking and listen. Answer the question. You ask me a question, I'll answer it.
I'll stop talking.
Here's the thing. I'll stop talking. Are you going to do the same, though?
Yes, sir.
Okay, go ahead.
My question, once again, do you even know where these scriptures come from?
You want me to answer that?
Please do.
Now hold that real quick. Song of Solomon 1 and 5.
Bring it out.
You can't read before a fictional character, brother.
Are you ask me a question, and I'm going to go according to the knowledge that I have, right? Ain't that what I'm supposed to do? Okay, let's read. Song of Solomon chapter 1 and verse 5.
Bring it out.
I am black. I am what? I am black. I am what? I am black. See, what you're rebelling against is Christianity,
not
the Bible.
Right.
Because our people always had the Bible.
That's right.
The
right.
Bible was wrote for our people, by our people.
That's right.
And then they
right.
took it and they put you in slavery. But they couldn't do away with the Bible. You know why? Because it's worldwide. It's spread in every country. Everybody knows about it. Every religion is based off of it. You understand?
That's wrong.
No, I'm about to ask you a question.
Okay.
Now I'm going to ask you, I'm going to go back and answer the question right. that you asked me already. Read it again. I am black, but comely. If this was such a racist white man book, wouldn't he took that out of it? Let's be real. See, but when they gave you the slave Bible during your enslavement, when you weren't allowed to read, that wasn't in it.
That's right.
That was not in the slave Bible.
Bring it out.
See, they kept the real Bible away from you. Just like they kept you learning. For 400 years, you wasn't able to read and write.
Right.
So like I said, I'm not. Issue right now. Issue right now. You're a part of our people. Issue. There you go. That's what white man taught you during slavery. Come on. I am black, but comely.
I'm black
and I'm beautiful. You ain't read that in your church. What pastor told you that? They told you you're a damn devil in church. They told you you're a whore and a whoremonger in church.
Where's this church?
I'm going to show you real quick. Because I want to destroy him. But go ahead. I'm on you though. I am black, but comely. O ye daughters of Jerusalem. Back to Deuteronomy 28:48. Now I'm going to redirect. Back to you now. Deuteronomy 28:48. Read it again. Deuteronomy 28, verse 48.
Bring it out.
Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies. And listen, so we can be clear. Hold that. Give me the Apocrypha. 2 Maccabees 6. Start at 6. Because this mindset of our people being together and everybody being together is a ploy of your oppressor from day one.
That's right.
He made you give up what your nationality is by force.
Right.
And then he waved an American flag over you and told you one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Right.
When that phrase was coined, you was a slave. So the same mentality that these white folks got back then, they got now. They smile at you but hate your guts. Ask them. If they're honest, they'll tell you. Come on. 2 Maccabees chapter 6 and verse 6. Neither was it lawful. Listen up, black sister, black woman that want to be the white woman all the time. Read. Neither was it lawful for a man to keep Sabbath days or ancient feasts.
or to profess himself at all to be a Jew.
This is the mindset of the white man. He said, it's unlawful for you to say that you're a Jew. You're not allowed to keep the customs of the Jew.
Right.
So whose customs must you adopt at that moment? Their customs.
That's right.
You understand? This is the history of when a white man first became a strong, powerful nation.
Right.
Under Alexander the Great.
Right.
Understand this. That's when he started attacking every dark nation. But guess what? You didn't read that prophecy on the hieroglyphs. You know where you read that prophecy at? In the book of Daniel. Before the Greeks even became a powerhouse.
He did have extra copy of every.
He told it in the Babylonian captivity. He said the Persians would come and take over. And then the Greeks would beat the Persians after that. And then the Romans would absorb the Greeks.
Right.
That's what the Bible says. You're not going to find that on the pyramid walls at all.
Right.
Where
you
at? Second Exodus chapter 6, verse 6.
That's right.
Hey, listen. Bro, remember, I let you ask me a question that I asked?
Yeah.
Now, real quick, right?
Okay.
We're about to read something. First, you got a phone, a smartphone?
Yeah.
All right. While I'm bringing this over, can you do two things at once? Can you patch your ear and rub your stomach?
Can you
chew bubble gum and walk? So you can Google and listen at the same time.
Excuse me,
Alexander the Greek. Chill out. To go and find where we were on cargo slave ships on the Egyptian hieroglyphs. Google it, right? But I need you to listen to this. I'm going to ask you questions while you Google it, right? Where you at? Neither was it lawful for a man to keep Sabbath days, or ancient feast, or to profess himself at all to be a Jew. And in the day of the king's birth, every month they were brought by bitter constraint to eat of the sacrifices.
So
it's instituting a holiday that everybody loves to celebrate, their birthday, right? But it's in honor of the king's birth. You understand? So all the time you turn it up, you might smoke crack on your birthday, you might drink liquor on your birthday,
right.
Smoke weed on your birthday,
right.
This is where you get it from.
Bring it up!
And when the feast of Bacchus was kept, the Jews were compelled to go in procession to Bacchus, carrying ivy.
So we were forced to honor their gods,
right.
And do away with your god. You had to become them. A chocolate-covered Edomite, that's what you had to become.
Bring it up! What is their word?
Moreover, there went out a decree to the neighbor cities of the heathen.
Hey, look at that.
By the suggestion of Ptolemy against the Jews, that they should observe the same fashions and be partakers of their sacrifice.
So, listen up, bro. It said that they forced us to become like them. We had to give up our history and become one people. That's what America did. That's where they got it from.
Well, let's just fucking hate each other then.
They don't believe that. Our black women don't believe that. Hey, listen. Our black women don't believe that. Because when you tell them to take off that hat, more than likely they got blonde wigs under their head.
Right.
We at? Verse 9. And whoso would not conform themselves to the manners of the Gentiles.
Hey, bruh.
Listen, come over here real quick.
Hey, bruh.
Come here. Read that again.
And whoso would not conform themselves to the manners of the Gentiles.
So whoever didn't conform themselves to like white Jesus, white Christianity, right? Just like this. This is where they got that from. Come on.
Should be put to death.
So this is their, everything they got, their mannerism, their claim to fame. But listen, their claim to fame, they got it from the Bible because the Bible is not no average book. They did not write the Bible. These are our ancestors, bro. King Solomon was a real dude. That's historical. King David was a real dude.
Why is it? See, because museums only have factual things in them. Museums got our ancestors in them. Explain to me, why does any museum on this planet have one person from the Bible in?
Hey, where's that scripture? I think it's in Ezekiel where our bones was left out. Hey, I'm going to ask you something. Hold on, real quick now.
I mean,
hold on, bro. Listen. Your fourth, when he get, while he's looking for the scripture,
right.
I'm going to say something to you. Your fourth great-great-grandma.
Right.
Where's she buried at?
Ain't no telling.
Why is it that you can't produce these records, but they gotta produce it? You got it? Google it for me, somebody.
Here's the thing. Our ancestors.
Just answer it first. You got it? Watch this. Jeremiah chapter 8, verse 1.
Bring it up.
At that time, saith the Lord, they shall bring out the bones of the kings of Judah.
Listen.
All of the bones of our leadership, like the people that you're requiring us to have produced in the museums. Come on. And the bones of his princes, and the bones of his priests, and the bones of the prophets, and the bones of the inhabitants of Jerusalem out of their graves. And they shall spread them before the sun and the moon and all the hosts of heaven whom they have loved and whom they have served and after whom they have walked and whom they have sought and whom they have worshipped. They shall not be gathered nor be buried. They shall be for dung upon the face of the earth. That's the reason why you don't know where these rumors are. It's because God already put that out there. Because you violate his law, statutes, and commandments, you won't even have the decency.
Listen, bro.
You ask the question, and we're giving you the answer.
That's right.
It said you won't even have the decency of getting a proper burial. Your bones will be scattered to the earth. Why? Because you're a slave. But we're going to go back to what we were saying before so I can ask you a question and you can answer. Deuteronomy 28 and 48.
Bring it out.
That was Jeremiah, not Ezekiel. Okay, good luck. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 48.
Bring it out.
Therefore shall thou serve thine enemies.
Now my
question to you is, do you serve someone?
Technically, yes.
Technically, yeah. But when it comes to anybody on the planet, who's the one that serves? Because do the Chinese serve anybody?
It's mainly us.
Because the Chinese have China. The Chinese have a government. The Chinese have an industry. They have import-export, right? You don't. You might work for an import-export company, right? All right, watch this. Therefore shall thou serve thine enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee. What you got to understand is the white man's not tough enough. He's not smart enough to come against us and beat us at war. It had to be something spiritual behind it. Because remember, when the Egyptians was at their zenith of power, everybody else was just crumbs. The so-called white man was a crumb, right? Every other nation. See, but when you're dealing with a nation, there's always going to be slavery. If there were slaves in America, there were slaves in Egypt. It's all on the walls.
It wasn't slavery.
Which
like
the Lord shall send against thee. And watch this.
In
hunger. So
like
do you got to serve the so-called white man for your food?
Yeah.
Come on. And in thirst for your water.
Yes.
And in nakedness. Nakedness, clothing, right? And in want of all things.
No.
When it says in want of all things, it's literally saying in all things.
Short,
even
like
your
college.
Opinion.
But check this out.
Well, see, that's where we differ from. I mean, I know
can
some of our
can you read the hieroglyphs?
So, according to this
no. But it's not like I can't learn them.
I never said that. You can. I'm with you on that. But what I'm asking you is,
listen, bro.
You got to answer my question. Can you read the hieroglyphs?
No.
So you had to depend on somebody else, right? Why is it that you can trust that information so easily and then you discredit this, but it is, wait a minute, because it'll show you signs and all type of stuff. Go ahead.
So I trust the information that I have because I trust it from other black men who've done it themselves. Not go by the blueprint, which...
You're looking at black men that done it themselves too. Why are we, why do you gotta look, why are you looking down on us, bro?
I'm just saying, what you're calling yourself is a fictional name.
Are we the Jews? Yeah or nay? Because earlier you said yeah. Now it's something different.
But the word Jew is just for communication purpose because that's all what people understand.
You're not Jeremiah.
You see what I'm saying? So
here's another thing that
I got to say yeah, Jew, but that's not.
So it goes both ways. In order for us to communicate, because we don't know no other language but English, we got to say what's in the English rendition of the word. So it goes back to the same thing, bro. The same exact thing. We have to communicate based off of what we know, how it was translated.
Exactly.
Okay, so
exactly. No, no, then we shouldn't be having
disagreement. I'm getting to you in a minute. Jeremiah chapter 14, verse 2.
Bring it out.
Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof language.
Hey, listen.
Judah is where the word Jew came from. Crack that for me. It's where the word, the name Jew came from, right? The tribe of Judah.
No, 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 no. See, that's what I'm saying. Misinformation.
What are you talking
about? Misinformation. Jew just comes from, look, it's a short form
of Judah.
The word Jewel. Jewel. Because that's how it's written.
Where did you get that from, bro? Where did you get that from, though? Because the Bible lets you know that Judah, Jew comes from Judah.
So you believe
period.
That.
That's all.
Right,
so you, what? All right. How can you talk about something that comes from the Bible and somebody else explains it to you, but the Bible can't
read? Bring it out.
Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof language. They are black unto the ground.
It told you that the tribe of Judah is black unto the ground.
That's
period.
Right.
So if this is the white man's book, why has it got so many references of the black man?
That's right, because it's been plagiarized from our ancestors.
So the white man is
going to
do something so detrimental to his empowerment by saying Christ is a black man.
No, because no, they just use simple brutality.
He's not going to jeopardize his power. You understand that? This is God. They couldn't touch the book. That's it.
No, come on. They can't touch truth.
To the mourners and the gates thereof language. See, you're the gates of our people. You're the leadership. You're the old man with the gray hair. That's dumb as a brick right now, bro.
No, because I'm not agreeing with
you. No, it's because you ain't exactly. You're rebellious as hell, bro.
I'm rebellious.
Yeah, because I told, I asked you, could you show us the daggone subscriptions on the Egyptian pyramids and inside the tombs of us going into slavery? You couldn't produce it. You know why? Because this is our people. This is our people wrote this book. Our people wrote this book. You understand that? You are the Israelites.
That's right.
I'm going to show you where he learned why it's the white man's book. Give me 2 Thessalonians chapter 2.
Bro,
you're fictional. The black man was made in the laboratory of America. That's where you was created at. You was created by your oppressor. Bro, you don't speak no other language. You can't even speak proper English. You want to talk to me about linguistics?
Why are you insulting him? Is that your arguing point?
Read.
You know,
anybody just going to put you down.
2 Thessalonians. Listen, so you can understand.
Can I provide you with some confirmation bias?
Our discussion is between our people. So leadership is going to check our people properly when they need to be checked. But that don't mean that there's no love there. What's wrong with you? But I'm going to show you where we get our mindset from, the devil.
Your Bible has been...
That's right, you say my Bible, right? Right? Hey, Ringo Starr, you said our Bible, right? No, you can't talk. This is our forum. Go down there and teach. You go teach homosexuality down there, not here.
2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 2. That ye be not soon shaken in mind, or be troubled, neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by letter, as from us, as that the day of Christ is at hand.
Because that's the problem. Because Christ didn't come back yet, is why you're shaky. Your faith is weak. But don't be troubled when people come about talking about it, though. Alright? Just understand. Understand. It's on the fly, big man. Understand, though. The end is coming. Don't leave yet. I want to show you where you got your mindset from. Understand that the destruction of our people or destruction of this country is at hand. You know why? Because I'm going to just give you some, hold on, can I give you some common sense stuff real fast?
Love the rhetoric.
Here's some common sense stuff. You don't give a damn about our people and about teaching because you don't have a corner set up nowhere. You don't have a classroom nowhere. See, but you don't want to seem like I'm not smart too. I gotta be smart just like them brothers. So you coming up here trying to teach us who are trying to wake up our people. What I'm saying to you is, bro, you don't care about our people. That's why you ain't trying to inform our people.
Is this a classroom?
You're out there lying.
Is it classroom? I believe you got love.
Are you married, bro? Are you married? Are you married? Yeah or nay? You married? Yeah or nay? You married? Because we teach against fornication. We say say you but not lay down with the black woman and have her open up her legs without marrying her.
Right.
You don't teach that. You don't give a damn about our people because abortions is killing our people.
That's right.
Single parent households is killing our people. That's how you determine whether or not somebody give a damn about you versus somebody who don't. You ain't got a mic. You should have your own mic. Why are you worried about our mic? You should have your own mic. Where's your classroom at if you care?
What I'm worried about is the misinformation.
Hey, listen. I ain't you teaching the right one then.
The misinformation.
Yeah, I understand it, though.
You're speaking a bunch of bullshit like that.
I'm going to show you something, Ringo Starr. Hold up.
Ringo Starr?
That ye be not so shaken in mind, or be troubled, neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by letter. As from us, as that the day of Christ is at hand.
Come on.
Because the day of Christ is at hand. Come on. Let no man deceive you. That's what's the problem. Let no man deceive you. But y'all think the Bible is just throwing it out there as any old man deceiving you. It's going to give you a description. It's going to let you know what man deceived you.
It's the greatest hits of deception. That's what it is.
By any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first.
So a falling away has to occur first.
You know what that falling away was? Hold that, give me Luke 2 and 23. You know what that falling away was? From you blacks and Latinos, from what your heritage is, where you come from, and who your God is, that's the falling away.
That's right.
It ain't written on no pyramid. Misinformation. You don't give a damn about your people. Come on. Luke chapter 21, verse 20. And when ye shall see
with your
verse 23. But woe unto them that are with child. Luke 2 and 23.
You're spitting fucking rhetoric that you don't even understand.
You don't understand nothing.
Oh, really?
You be quiet. You just chill out. Go teach your people something.
I'm sorry, I'm upsetting you.
Luke chapter 2, verse 34.
Bring it out!
And Simeon blessed them and said unto Mary his mother, Behold, this child is set for the fall and rising again of many in Israel.
So the fall and the rising again of many in Israel, because Christ lets you know in Luke 21 and 20 on down to 25 that you're going to go into slavery. Listen to what Christ said.
Right.
You're going to go into slavery. Why? Because Moses told us already in Deuteronomy chapter 28 that you're going to be placed on cargo slave ships.
That's right.
The rising and falling of many in Israel. Your fall is you became slaves. Your rising is that Christ's disciples are back on the block.
That's right.
That's the rising again. Back to Thessalonians.
You missed the whole point of the Bible.
I don't care what you say. The Bible don't even belong to you. You shouldn't even read it.
I've read it twice. I studied.
You shouldn't even read it. Where I say Thessalonians?
Yeah, you like
2 Thessalonians.
Just keep quoting that rhetoric.
Go where you left off at. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 3.
Bring it
Let no man deceive you by any means. Those are deceivers.
Right.
Trying to take you away from the word of Christ. That's at the eighth. Mr. Edom, I don't want to read. We're about to read you in the Bible.
Bring it out.
For that day shall not come except there come a falling away first. And that man of sin. Turn that mic up. The man of what? Hold on. The man of what? And that man of sin.
There's a man of sin that walks this face of the earth.
And I'm going to flat out say it because we're not scared to say it. We don't say it and whisper like,
say it.
It's the white man. The Bible said it.
Since you are free of
we
sin.
Don't usually entertain
anybody.
We talk to our people about making baby mamas out of our women. We talk to our people about gangbanging. That's what we don't really entertain them. But since he butted in our conversation, we're going to read him in the Bible. And that man of sin, what? Be revealed.
Be revealed,
because this is what we're telling you. That's the devil in Revelations chapter 12.
That's right.
Come on.
Woo, yeah.
And that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition, the son of wickedness. Come on. Who opposes and exalteth himself above all that is called God.
He opposes and exalteth himself above all that is called God.
Everything that's called God, guess what? You are called by his name. He exalted himself over you. Look at his image.
image.
Am I his slave then?
Look at his image. Did he not exalt himself above all that is called God?
Am I his slave then?
Give me Psalms 82. Slave? Give me Psalms 82. Hold that though.
Am I God's just remember, slave then?
He exalted himself over all that is called God.
You just pinged right. yourself into two corners.
Shut up.
You did.
Be quiet.
Oh, silence.
The day of the buck dancing, shoe shuffling is over.
That's right.
It's over. It is finished. You got it?
What you doing here?
Psalms chapter 82, verse 6.
Bring it
I
up.
Have said, ye are God. Oh, wait a minute. God said that you're God's.
That's right.
Black woman, you need to understand this. That black man in the household, God set him up as a God in the household.
That's right.
But the devil exalts himself over all that is called God.
Right.
You and the Most High God. You know why? Because he said he is God's son. But when we read the Bible, God's son looks like you. Matter of fact, he's darker than you. A lot of y'all is light brown, dark brown. And then there's very few of you that's really, really dark skinned, blue-black. There's one blue-black brother down there that I see, and that's Christ's complexion right there.
That's right.
That's what we inspire to be like in the inside. Blue-black, like our Lord and Savior.
That's right.
Not saying the light-skinned, because I'm light-skinned. Not saying that the light-skinned brothers and the light-skinned sisters is not righteous. I'm not, you know, being spoken about in reverence, though. Come on. I have said, ye are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High. But ye shall die like men, because God said you're gods on the earth. But you'll die like men. Why? Because God said that if you follow his law, statutes, and commandments, you'll be the rulers of every nation on the planet. And you'll get eternal life and be rulers forever. That's what Christ promises us, right? But you're not like that now. You're a slave.
Right.
To the point you hate yourself more than your oppressor because he housed us in projects. And the only one to lash out against is each other. It's just like spouses in a house. They're frustrated about the bills. They're frustrated about the job situation. Who do they lash out against first? Or a mother frustrated about how they got to teach the kids during the COVID. Can't go to school, so they lash out on their children from their frustration. It's the exact same thing we do with gangbanging. The exact same thing. But who taught you that? You don't want to die like men. You want to live like gods, kings, and princesses.
Right.
The Bible calls Christ an austere man. If anybody knows what an austere man is, it's hard, unyielding. Don't play no games. Although he loved his people, but he didn't play any games. He tell you that you're going to die if you don't repent. That's what he says. Anybody who got something against it, you say that you believe in Christ and believe in the Bible. No, you don't. You believe in this man. You believe in that man. Because he's his representative. Because the Bible calls him the man of sin. Watch. Come on.
2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 4. Who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God.
Remember I said that you're called God. You're called by his name. And this is the man that taught you that it's okay to do whatever you want to do. You can be a homosexual and a lesbian. You can celebrate Christmas and birthdays. All of that is okay. But you're somebody that don't read the Bible. If you read the Bible, Christmas is in Jeremiah chapter 10. It's not allowed. Birthdays is in the book of Job.
It's all Saints Day.
Job's children were killed because they celebrated birthdays. But why don't your pastor teach that? And as we is explaining to this brother right here, he's not rebellious against the Bible. He's rebellious against Christianity. And we're winning. Yes, rebel against the slave master's religion. Yes. The Bible is something different though. Come on.
Exalted himself above all that is called God or that is worship, so that he as God.
He is God. He pretends to be God. Here's his picture.
I like your shining glass.
Sitteth in the temple of God showing himself that he is God.
Who sits in the temple of God pretending to be God? Is it not your friendly neighborhood Edomite? Huh? Is it not that person who sits in the temple of God pretending to be God? To be righteous? Come on.
Remember ye not that when I was yet with you, I told you these things.
So when y'all leave and get on that bus, remember what we said, because we told you this. We told you this. Because everybody mimics the other nations, like men with bald heads and shaved faces. That's a Greek custom. Women in pants. That's a Greek custom. You learned that from the white man. Your pastor walks around looking like the white man. That's a proven fact. Alexander the Greek can't brought that to you. A flaming homosexual brought that mindset to you. That imagery. Come on.
And now ye know what withholdeth that he might be revealed.
I need you to read it again. If you started in the middle, read it again.
And now ye know what withholdeth that he might be revealed in his time.
So the end has been withheld from you seeing right now until the man of sin is revealed. This is his time of rulership. We're not going to reveal the man of sin once he loses his rulership. That's foolishness. He's an afterthought after that, from that moment on. Come on.
For the mystery of iniquity doth already work.
What is the mystery of iniquity? The mystery of sin. It's because we can explain it to you that it's the Edomite. We can explain it to you that you're following after evil and idolatry. But you won't see it a lot of times because it's a mystery to you. Come on.
Only he who knows letteth will let until he be taken out of the way.
Because there's going to come a time where he is taken out of the way, because the Most High is going to remove him from the position of power. The promise is to place us in power. See you, Mr. Edomite.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.